हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज मी सौरभ अवस्थी, एन इंग्लिश टीचर एट माउंट लिट्रा जी स्कूल झांसी। एंड टुडे आई ब्रॉट अ वीडियो ऑफ क्लास 11, द समर ऑफ द ब्यूटीफुल वाइट हॉर्स, रिटन बाय विलियम शेरियन। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट टू अर्मेनियन बॉयज, अरम एंड मुराद, हु बिलोंग टू द गैरोगेलियन फैमिली। देयर ट्राइब इज नोन फॉर देयर ऑनेस्टी। They were poor and can hardly earn money for food. They both longed to ride a horse. Murad one day stole a horse from a farmer a month ago. So here now we are going to start with the summary of the chapter. But before that, let's read about the author of the chapter. William Sharon is an American Armenian author. He was born on August 31, 1908 in California to Armenian immigrants from Turkey. His father died when Sharon was just 3 years old. He and his siblings had to be put into an orphanage. But luckily, 5 years later, they were reunited with their mother. Even during hard times, Sharon's spirits were high. His writings often celebrated the joy of living in spite of poverty, hunger, and insecurity. Though Sharon had to leave school at 15, he educated himself by reading and writing. Later, he continued his education on his own, supporting himself by taking up odd jobs. Sharon's mother showed him some of his father's writings, which influenced his early writing. Sharon's works had a strong autobiographical touch, especially his later works. Some of his well-known works are Here Comes, There Goes You Know Who, in 1961, Not Dying of 1963, Days of Life and Death and Escape to the Moon of 1971, and Places Where I've Done Time of 1975. In 1940, Sharon refused the Pulitzer Prize for his play The Time of Your Life, saying that it was no more great or good than anything else he had written. So here, William Sharon died on May 18, 1981 at the age of 73, which shows that he was a great author, the one who left his name behind for us. So here, this was all about the author of the chapter, The Summer of the Beautiful White Horse. And now we will start with the summary of the chapter, where I will explain the whole summary of the chapter so that you can understand it well and can learn something from the chapter. So here, Aram and Murad were two poor boys who belonged to the Armenian Garoglenian family, who were known for their honesty since the 11th century. One early morning, when Aram was asleep and was enjoying pleasant dreams, his cousin Murad showed up to his window with a beautiful white horse. Aram could not believe it and was thinking it was a dream, but since there was a little light outside, he knew this for sure, that the horse was real. As they were poverty stricken, he couldn't believe that the horse was their own. He was trying to figure out if the horse had been stolen by his cousin. Murad had come to invite him for a ride along. He asked him to make it quick before everyone in the world wakes up. Aram wore his clothes and jumped out of the window and sat behind Murad on the horse. They rode on the old countryside of the area where they lived, Walnut Avenue. After some time, Murad asked him to get off as he wanted to ride the horse alone. Aram asked him if he could also ride the horse alone just like him, to which Murad said they will see as it was for his own safety. He got to know that Murad had stolen the horse a month ago and was riding it every morning. When Aram got his chance of a ride, the horse took him to the vineyard and threw him off and ran away. After searching for 30 minutes, Murad finally managed to find the horse, and they hid him in a deserted vineyard that had some oats and alfalfa. Murad had a way with everything, especially horses. He knew how to handle every type of animal and also humans. Every morning, for 2 weeks, they would take the horse for a ride and then hide it again. One day, John Byro came to Aram's house to talk to his uncle, Khusrov, who was an irritated and loud man who shouted at almost everything. Byro told him about his missing horse, whom he bought at $60. For 1 month, he couldn't find it and he walked for 10 miles to come to their house. Khusrov rode at him and told him, "It's no harm, pay no attention to it." Byro became irritated by his attitude and he went away. So here, author is saying that Aram went to Murad and told him about the missing horse of Byro and asked him not to return the horse until he learns to ride it. Murad told him that it would take 1 year for him to learn to ride the horse. He further angrily added that they could not be thieves as their tribe is known for honesty, and said that they would return the horse after 6 months. So now, one day, on their way back to hide the horse to the hidden spot, they met John Byro, who was going back to the town. He talked to them and carefully examined the horse. He admitted that the horse looked exactly like the one he had, but since he knew his parents and the honesty of their family, he didn't believe that they had his missing horse. He assumed it was a twin horse. Murad managed to let Byro assume that it was not his horse, so they went away. The next morning, both of them took the horse back to Byro's vineyard and put it in the barn. The dogs followed them all along quietly and they left the place. And at last, the same afternoon, John Byro came back to his house to tell his mother about his horse who had come back. He was happy and was astonished to see the horse's better temper, and it was stronger than ever. Uncle Khusrov again rode, "Quiet, man, quiet. Your horse has been returned. Pay no attention to it." So like this, finally, the primary message of the story is of the Summer of the Beautiful White Horse is that despite social or economic challenges, there are some truths which are absolute and should be practiced under and all condition. It is undeniable that the story is set within a family that is poor. Their poverty is not used as a crutch or something that limits the emotional quotient of the boys or the people in the community. The boys' love for the horse is genuine and sincere. not motivated out of some ulterior motive or of greed or economic want. Their love for the animal is quite authentic. When they return the horse, they have a genuine understanding that they need to return what is not theirs. They are not motivated by anything else other than the highly human reaction of wanting to make right what is wrong. The reaction of the horse's owner, John Biro, is also very real and valid. He knows very well the boys have taken the horse, but gives multiple opportunities for the boys to recognize the consequences of their action. Ironically enough, the owner shows a sense of charity and a goodwill, and this benefits him, as the horse is much more manageable and well conditioned as a result of the boy's work with the horse. In the final analysis, when we examine the encounter of the boys, the horse and the owner, there is a trend that while economic hardships area strong factor in how we behave, they are not a determinant one. There is a realm of human action that can lie outside the strictly casual world of economics. The setting of the story seems to be depression time in California, which makes reading even more interesting. So students, I hope that you must have understood the summary of the chapter, The Summer of the Beautiful White Horse. So now we are ending this video here, and go through the video twice or thrice so that you can understand the chapter very well. So now, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay at home. Thank you so much.